I was introduced to you with Chasing Summer. How do you relate to the person who created that album?
Oh man, still the same guy, a little older, a little wiser, you know, a little more seasoned, a little more experienced. I look back at the version of the person I was when I was writing Chasing Summer, and I'm extremely like sad for that guy. You know, he was going through a lot and nobody knew, you know, and he looks at me and smiles because he knows he has something to look forward to, you know, and there's just been so much growth through pain and through, you know, work. And, you know, I'm proud of both SiRs because, you know, without one, there wouldn't be the other.
As always, it always has to come with that balance, right? It does. How do you relate and how do you emote when you're on that stage knowing that that was a past self? Like, how do you try to attach new memories to those tracks?
No, it's the same way I perform the heavy songs, because you got to think, I wrote these songs and, you know, performing them now, they're 2-3 year old songs. Some of them are 8 year old songs, you know what I mean, that I just decided to put out. So, you know, it's the same with every performance. All I'm trying to do is be present. You know what I mean? Because every song deserves its, you know, respect. So I try to be present through the whole set, which is a very difficult thing to do and a very daunting task, especially how emotional some of these songs make me, you know? But I think I've gotten good at it. The first few shows I broke down, you know, even today was kind of like at the end of the set, I was like losing it. You know what I mean? I'm an emotional wreck after all of this trauma.
Yeah, you're going through it all. You're like, you're literally meeting all yourselves. And you're like, hey, come with me for this song.
Right?
And this one too.
Right.
And let me put you down because I got to pick this one up.
Man, a few of the songs I don't even like performing, but I have to because they're fan favorites. And, you know, they're versions of myself I definitely don't want to let out. You know what I mean? But we won't say what songs.
I really want to know, though.
Can you guess?
I don't know. That's the thing.
What song do you think I just hate to perform because it puts me in a place that I don't want to be?
Well, I think in order for me to answer that, I would have to reveal a lot about myself.
Same.
So, you know what I mean?
All right, so I'm married.
Yeah.
I'm SiR.
Yeah.
Made some mistakes. What song would be the worst song for me to sing?
I mean, Dream Girl, like John Redcorn?
John Redcorn, no, because that's a very introspective song. That's Why I Love You. Let's just start there.
Yeah. Okay. That's the one that it hits a little bit.
Sonically amazing.
Beautiful.
Feature-wise, amazing.
Right.
Lyrically, not the song I want to be singing.
Yeah. How do you do it? Because that's the song that we were like, SiR, thank you. Because you really did. You kind of gave us the words when we didn't have it. And
yeah.
We had to confront ourselves, right?
Oh, yeah.
And thinking about Heavy, right? When did you know that you were making this album? Did you set out to make it? Did you start with a couple tracks, take a few steps back? How did this Heavy process come about?
Sheesh. Heavy is like probably 3 years old, with a few new records that we added as we got healthy. But yeah, I started that playlist in the depths of my addiction, in the depths of depression, and in one of the worst places. Which is funny because some of the best records, man, came from that, you know. But as I healed, as I set myself to the side to heal and focus on myself and my family, I started to see a through line of light at the end of the tunnel, but so much darkness. So, you know, the playlist was kind of creating itself as I was recreating myself. And, you know, I looked up and we had too many songs. So, you know, Heavy is definitely a labor of love, but it's my life in a nutshell for the last like 3 years, you know what I mean? And it's a beautiful like victory for me. I'm not worried about like what it's selling. I'm not worried about how it looks to people. I mean, I've survived those lyrics. I survived that. That's like really me. That really happened. And, you know, this is for me. I love that I have fans that listen to it and again can, you know, understand what's going on and feel for me, but it's literally for me, you know what I mean? And I thank God for this one for sure.
So when this album was over, were you like, okay, I'm gonna give it away? Or how? What was the process of being ready to release it? Because it took a little minute.
It took a while. No. It was me. It was me being healthy. You know, we definitely were sitting on this in 2023. We started to drop our last single and, you know, I just relapsed, had a horrible relapse. And, it set me back, you know, and I had to really, you know, really know that I was ready. You know, I had to know that I was ready. Everybody else around me was doing everything they could to help me get healthy, but I had to decide that I wanted to be healthy. What's up, y'all? This is my proof.
That's love. Yeah. That's love for real.
I had to decide I wanted to be healthy, and I had to decide that, you know, I was, you know, ready to share this message. And, you know, it took a while, but I just thank God for top people like him. You know, he definitely did everything he could to, like, be patient with me and give me all the time I needed. And, you know, my wife, my family, I got to be thankful to them for just supporting me the way they do. You know what I mean? I wouldn't be able to be where I am today without, you know, my family, my mom, my family, my wife.
You have a lot of family around you, and that's one. We just saw some. We saw your crew, right?
Yeah.
So you have the people who are with you on this tour day in and day out.
Yeah.
You've got your musical family. You've got TDE, right? TDE is on fire right now. Every single one of y'all is just, like, firing on all cylinders. And it's something that's really impressive to see coming from a roster. You mentioned Top being such a supporter. What is something that you've learned from through your label mates that you've maybe learned through them that you wanted to incorporate into your practice as you've come into Heavy?
Oh, man. I mean, for the next project, I'm just going back to the basics. Hustle like I'm broke. You know what I mean? Like, no matter what I've accomplished, I need to focus on what's next, and I need to dig down and, like, really start writing some songs. You know, I've been working so much on touring and everything that I haven't had time to, like, really do what I love most. So, you know, I'm just going back to the basics, going to the studio, sitting down, shutting up. Y'all ain't gonna see me for a year. And then all of a sudden, it's gonna be music video after music video, and we drop it and we ready to go.
Well, I'm ready for that.
Yeah, honestly. No, for sure. I'm not, I will never be gone 5 years. I'm not that type of artist. I should have never been gone that long in the first place. You know what I mean? So I got points to prove now. You know, so yeah, I'm excited about the future.
So that reminds me of, you did an interview with Rolling Stone's Megan Jordan, and you talked about how, obviously, through your journey of recovery, using music as a diary of sorts. As you're on this tour, do you jot notes about things that you're going through? Do you keep it until you have that year where you get to sit back and process, or how's your process?
My process is pretty archaic, honestly. I'm like, send me beats. Yeah. I got a folder of beats, and I literally just wait until it's time for me to get in the studio, and I pull up my folder of beats. I'm simple. Or I make a beat, or I start a piano. You know what I mean? Those kind of, like, I'm that kind of simple, where the lyrics will be based off of the feeling I get, the color that I hear
right
in the music. You know what I mean? You know?
The color that you hear.
Yeah.
What color do you feel like right now? What's the color of SiR today?
I'm very, I'm like a deep, dark blue.
Why deep, dark blue?
It's a lot going on outside of music. Yeah. But like almost a little purple, you know what I mean? The darkest of blues.
Like a midnight.
Midnight blue.
Midnight blue is what we're feeling? Mm-hmm. I mean, I love that you can say that and still say it with a smile, because even though it's hard, you're still showing up and you're here.
I have no choice.
That part.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much for sitting down with
thank
us.
Thank you. This was wonderful.
This was great.
I really appreciate this conversation.
I really appreciate it too.
Yeah.